Hey guys, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss oroantral communication and oroantral fistula. Before we begin, if you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button so that you never miss a video from me. And now let's begin. As the name itself suggests, oroantral communication means an unnatural communication or connection between the oral cavity and the andrum, means the maxillary sinus. Why does this happen? The most common reason for this is extraction of maxillary molars and premolars. You see, in the region of the maxillary posterior teeth, the floor of the andrum is very thin, only 1 to 7 millimeters. But this is not the only reason. Sometimes, periapical lesions can destroy a part of the sinus floor. Sometimes, during enucleation of a cyst or a tumor in that area, the instruments we are using can perforate the sinus floor and create a communication. A tooth or root can get displaced into the sinus while extraction, so that can create this connection. Infections like osteomyelitis or trauma to the face, or even orthognathic surgeries like Lefort osteotomy can be the reason. Now, when this communication is left untreated, it can progress to become oroantral fistula. So what is a fistula? When this communication gets epithelized, meaning lined by cells from the oral epithelium, this is called as oroantral fistula. And this happens when the oroantral communication is there for at least 48 to 72 hours. So fistula means a permanent epithelized tract. That is why we should close it surgically within 48 hours so that the communication doesn't become permanent. What will happen if we leave the oroantral communication untreated? 50% of the patients will experience sinusitis within 48 hours and 90% within 2 weeks. Because you see, when there is a communication, oral bacteria can penetrate the sinus. So that's why surgical closure of the oroantral communication is very important. But the decision about how to treat an oroantral communication depends on the size of the communication, the time of diagnosis, and the presence or absence of infection. So if the sinus is healthy and the size of the opening is less than 2 millimeters, it can close on its own. But if it's larger than that, it will not heal spontaneously and it can progress to become an oroantral fistula if we leave it untreated. In a small size communication with a size of about 2 mm to 6 mm, you can place a collagen plug into the socket and give figure of 8 sutures. If there is maxillary sinusitis present, it should be treated first with antibiotics before closing the defect. To close an oroantral communication, there are several treatment options. There is this flowchart given by Vishers that gives an overview of all the treatment options. Among all of these, soft tissue closure is the treatment of choice for the closure of most oroantral communications. So let's discuss that first. The most common and oldest surgical technique is the buccal advancement flap designed by Reherman. So it's like this. First, two buccal divergent vertical incisions are made from the extraction socket to the buccal vestibule.